Hello everybody, my name is NicoD. Today I'm back with an old single board computer. It's the NanoPC-T3 Plus. It's got an octa-core CPU of 8 times 1.4 GHz. It's got 2 GB of DDR3 RAM. So this board should be really fast. I am gonna compare it with the Cadas FIM 2 Max. So the Cadas FIM has got 4 cores of 1 GHz and then 4 cores of 1.5 GHz. Actually 1.4 GHz, but they say 1.5. So this should be faster than this, but this has got 3 GB of RAM DDR4. This has got 2 GB of DDR3 RAM. Otherwise, you can compare it also with the Android XU4, which has got 4 cores of 2 GHz and then 4 cores of 1.4 GHz. But the Android XU4 is 32 bits and this is 64 bits, just like the Cadas FIM 2 Max. Both are 64 bits. So let's go to the specs. The CPU is a Samsung S5P6818 octa-core at 1.4 GHz. Who chose that name? The GPU is a Mali 400 MP4, so it's a quad-core GPU. It's got 2 GB of DDR3 RAM. There's 3 normal USB ports, so big ports, type A, and 1 micro USB port. You can also get 1 more USB through the GPIO pins. It's got HDMI 1.4, so there's no 4K at this board, only 1080p. It's got 16 GB of eMMC, it's gigabit Ethernet, there's Bluetooth on boards, there's 3 LSD connectors plus the HDMI connector. So you've got the RGB LCD connector, the LVDS connector and the MIPI DSI connector. Also, there are 2 different camera connections, the MIPI CSI connector and the DVP camera connector. So this board packs a lot of things. So now let's see how well it does. So for the operating system, I type in NanoPC T3 Plus downloads. So the second one here is a friendly ARM. So I go there and get started. So I tried the Lubuntu version of friendly ARM first, but there were a lot of problems with this. I cannot upgrade. There's a lot of errors on it. So this is a bit of shame, but there's things that do work here and that don't work on other operating systems. So the one I chose was here, the eFlasher, to flash it onto the eMMC. The other distros are only to put on SD cards. After I installed Lubuntu on the eMMC, I downloaded Armbian and I put this on an SD. You cannot put it onto the eMMC yet, so I had to put it on an SD, but Armbian really works very well. There are a few things that don't work, like the onboard microphone and the headphone jack, and also you cannot shut down. It restarts instead of shutting down. Here I am in Armbian. It's a really great distro. All the programs work on it. It's very customizable. Also, there's a lot of great tools made by the Armbian people. These people are very talented. They make this for a lot of single board computers and it's free to use. But of course, they put in so much time. So if you use Armbian a lot, please think of donating something. Here you can donate. You can either way pay with PayPal or buy something for them on Amazon or pay with Bitcoin. If you've got something left on your PayPal that you don't use, donate it to them. Every little bit will count for them because if we want to keep using this and if we want to have a great Armbian, then we have to donate.
Get out of here!
Thank you.
First on the BMW Blender benchmark in 720p to be able to compare it with the slower single board computers. So it did it in 32 minutes and 20 seconds. So compared to the ROG 64, it's twice as fast. Compared to the Raspberry Pi 3B, it's more than 4 times faster. Compared with the Banana Pi M20, it's amazingly fast. Compared to these, it's already very fast. Now the BMW Blender benchmark in 1080p. So the NanoPC-T3 Plus did it in 1 hour and 9 minutes and 38 seconds. So if we go and see how the other single board computers did this, compared to the Odroid XU4, which was my fastest until now, which done it in 1 hour and 12 minutes. So the NanoPC is 3 minutes faster than the Odroid XU4. So this shows which powerhouse it is. But of course, in this we can see that 64 bits computers have an advantage in Blender. The Odroid XU4 is 32 bits, and this is why it did it slower than the NanoPC. So compared to the other single board computers, you see there's no match for this NanoPC T3. This board chips with an okay heatsink. It could have been a bit better, but I'm already happy with it. So the no load and no fan temperature is 53 degrees Celsius, and the max load is 91 degrees Celsius, but it takes a long time before it reaches this. So it's about 8 minutes when it reaches 91 degrees Celsius. It doesn't throttle, maybe it should throttle a bit when it goes this far, but it's already good. I don't think many people will use this board constantly at the max, and so you can use it without a fan. So with the fan, the no load temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, and the max load is 55 degrees Celsius. So this is a very good temperature for an octa-core single board computer.
Powering up.
The power consumption of the NanoPC T3 Plus is rather okay. So the no load is 0.75 amps, and the max load is 1.8 amps. So this is okay. It's less than the Tinkerboard, but it's more than the CADAS FIM 2 Max. But this board is also faster than the CADAS FIM 2 Max.
You are terminated.
So my conclusion about the NanoPC T3 Plus is it's a very good single board computer. It's very fast. I've been using it now for a bit more than a month, and I'm very happy with it. It does everything I needed to do. Also, the YouTube playback is good. In 1080p, there's some dropped frames, but it's watchable. It's better than on the XU4, so that's good. Otherwise, I love it a lot. Every program that I need to use works on it. The only thing in Armbian is it doesn't work on the eMMC, and also you cannot shut down, so you have to pull out the plug to shut down. So that's my conclusion. I hope you like my video. Thank you for watching. See you later. Bye.
I'll be back.